Yo, welcome to another video. It's the provider here again with another video. And basically today in this video, I've been getting a lot of emails about people asking, what one person asked if you can format a written USB, like, I don't know exactly what he's talking about, but from what I'm getting, like a written USB, I think what he's trying to say is that you can't format it the way you're supposed to. One of the reasons maybe is because it doesn't even show up here. And as you can see, I have my my USB connected right now. You can't see, but I'm telling you, I have my USB connected right now, and for some reason it won't show up. So I actually know why. It's because I flashed it with Belena Etcher. I put in some type of jailbreak for phones and all that. If you guys know what boot rain is, then that's what it does, and it won't let me format it because, I mean, I can't even see it here. And all the partitions and all that things, I think it probably blocks it from showing up. I don't know, but whatever it is, it doesn't want me to format it. Once it's flashed, it stays flashed, and there's nothing you can do. But I found a solution. The mega god Rufus 3.10 is pretty much the one and only USB destroyer ever. Like, not really destroyer, but destroyer in the sense that it'll format any type of locked USB, encrypted USB, it doesn't matter what it is. This thing will format it, destroy its encryption, and fucking just make it better. And clean it, very clean, so you can use it and put apps and stuff like that in there, so you can use it for whatever you want to use it for. So let me just get you started with this. But like I said, over here, I'm looking at this PC right now. I mean, I'm looking at nothing but my main. And usually, you guys already know, if you guys connect your USB, it would show up over here as an extension or whatever with your USB name. My USB name is no label, and it has 4 gigabytes in it. So, and it's not showing here. This is my main PC, as you all know. And this is my DVD drive, because my PC has a DVD drive as well, so I can play movies and all that stuff. but yeah, so let's go ahead and, this is going to be a pretty quick video because there's not really much to say here, but I'll put this down in the link below. You don't have to worry, I'm not going to put you guys through a bunch of stupid ads. I mean, I really don't care about that. I'm just going to put the link down, direct link, direct download, and you'll know that it's a real download when you see this with the administrator permission and all that stuff. And yeah, so let's go ahead and get started. So it's going to prompt you, user account control will prompt you, because this is administrator, it requires administrator privileges to do it, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. Sorry for the black screen, I know that happens in videos. Alright, so as you can see, I'm not lying, my USB device is plugged in, 4 gigabytes, disk 1, that's what they call it, I don't know why, but it's no label, there you go. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to select either disk or ISO image. So with what I did to encrypt my USB with boot rain is I used Belena Etcher to flash it. And the thing I used, I already deleted it. It's not there anymore, but I deleted it a long time ago. And I've been trying to figure out ever since how to destroy it. I just wipe it clean, because I've been trying to do... I even watched a couple other YouTube videos, and they showed me a couple command prompt tips and all that stuff, and none of that helped. I even tried restoring my computer. That had nothing to do. That was a pretty stupid thing, because it has nothing to do with my laptop, so that was stupid of me to do, but anyways, I tried searching for plenty of videos, and I've been wasting a lot of time, and none of those things turned out to work, but thank God I actually found Rufus here, and I've already tried it, but I formatted the disk one more time just to make this video, so I've already tried it, and I know for sure this works. I'm just going to do this here for the tutorial. So, what I chose was non-bootable. I don't know about you guys. I don't know if you guys understand what these are, but I just choose whatever makes more sense to me. You know, non-bootable. I really don't want it to be booted, so I'm just going to choose non-bootable. I don't want to mess with any of this, so I just leave it out. Whatever non-bootable selects, I leave it at that. You know, all that. So, show advanced drive options, list USB hard drive. Okay, yeah, we don't care about that. Now this, volume label. So what do you want it to be? Do you still want it to be no label, or do you want to change it? So I'm just going to change it to storage, because now, since I'm going to format it, I'm going to put my storage in it. So my apps and downloads and pictures and all that stuff, right? So it's going to put storage. File system, FAT, FAT, or FAT32, XFAT. I don't know what the fuck that is, but I just choose FAT. Because that's the default, as you can see right there. And I'm not going to mess with cluster size. I never mess with that. I don't do any of that. But this is easy enough for you to, like, just think about what makes more sense. And if it makes more sense, just go with it, you know. If you see default there, then just go with default. And then show advanced format options. And the thing you want to select is checked format, I mean, quick format, and create extensive label and icon files. I do not know what that is, but I think, I mean, from what I, like I said, I did this again. I did this one time before, or two times before. And I selected all these options that you see right here that I selected are the ones that I used it, and it still worked. So you do that, quick format, because if you don't select that, it's going to take a longer time, and it probably won't even format. So this is select quick format, so they can just wipe everything out. And, guys, start. You just click on start, and as you can see, warning, all data on the device, no label, blah, 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 will be destroyed. And I like it when Rufus tells you that. It will be destroyed. Now, that motivates me to just want to click on this freaking OK button even more. So I'm just going to click it. Deleting partitions. I don't know how to fucking delete partitions. Writing master boot record. I mean, okay, and it's done. It was that easy. I mean, the boot rain thing is like 400-something megabytes, right? And, bro, it took just like 10 seconds to remove everything. So you don't have to do this again. So you just close. And let's go ahead and check. Look at that. Look at that. Storage E. My new name. This is my drive. This is how much I have and all that. I mean, bro. And it's clear. You know. So you don't need to worry about this. I think. Hold on. Let me format it one more time. Let me format it one more time. So I'm just going to do this again. Non-bootable, MBR. Storage, I'm going to leave it at that. Let's just uncheck that, right? And then we start again. It will be destroyed, as always. I just love hearing that. I love it. Okay, it does whatever. Okay, perfect. It is done. No, let me just delete that. Okay, so I'm just going to go back there again, and you will see. On this PC, there's absolutely nothing. So it's going to be normal. You don't have that Rufus modification in there. It's completely normal. It's as if it was brand new, not used at all. You go in there, file's empty. And now I can put in my storage in there. And yes, my storage is pretty big. This file is pretty big. So it's going to take a little time. But I mean, you can move whatever you want there. It's free for you to use. It's no longer written. It's no longer encrypted. It's no longer hidden out of your site, so that there's no way you can access it. It's now there, officially there. You can read it. It's a normal, simple storage device, USB device, whatever you want to call it. It's all fixed, and everything has been destroyed. And that's from one of my viewers that emailed me asking for that, and I am really glad I got to solve it for him, and I hope I can help a lot of other people around there too with this problem, because apparently it turns out to be an easy solution, because as you can see, this only took me aside from the introduction and the describing what the video is going to be like. I mean, basically it took like 3 minutes to format a drive that I basically was searching for months, almost a year to try to format it. I mean, wow, you know. And I finally, you see, there you go, good as normal. There you go. I got my whole storage there. I can eject like a normal USB, and then I have removed my USB officially, and now I can use it on any other computer. I can plug it in right back to this one in case I have to restore it or something like that, and I want to get my files back. I go to my storage, extract it here, you know, blah, 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 whatever. And that's pretty much it, you guys. And I also have another video for you guys on how to delete premium, because that's another email that I got. How do you get free Spotify premium? Now, I'm gonna tell you guys this in advance. This is just for educational purposes. I'm not doing this because, no, I'm just quick disclaimer. This is all for educational purposes. He want, I mean, my recipient wants to know how to do this. I'm just here to show him, and that's it. I'm not gonna encourage anybody to actually do it, but if that's them, then that's them. I'm not gonna force anybody, but that's that. And but that's gonna be the next video. It's actually late today, so I'm pretty tired, so I'm just gonna go ahead and jump and crash. But yeah, maybe tomorrow or the next day or something, I'm gonna make a video based on that. But there's actually been a problem for me. When I click on installer for Spotify, it gives me a Windows Store installation, Spotify, blah 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 blah, and please uninstall that version first. Honestly, I have checked everywhere. Like, I have searched right here, app data over here, and honestly, that's all I get. There's no such thing as Spotify here. And if I were to come look at local as well, I don't see any Spotify here. If I come look at local low, there's nothing but Microsoft, and I click on that. Internet Explorer, there's really nothing there. Click on this, there's nothing there. So it's useless. And I go back to roaming, and as you can see right here, there's literally nothing. And I click on Microsoft, honestly, there's really nothing here. I click on Windows. Yeah, from here on out, there's nothing else. So there's no sign, there's no file of Spotify. So I think it is completely gone. Maybe I'm getting this message as a as an error or something. Maybe it's false or whatever, I don't know. But whatever it is, it's preventing me from installing Spotify again. So I'm gonna try to figure that out. Unless you guys have a video for me or whatever, I'd really appreciate it. That would save me all the trouble. But in the meantime, I'm gonna go ahead and figure this problem out, and I will also include that in a video. I will put in the solution. Whatever I get, I will put in the solution and share that with you guys. I will be happy to show you guys whatever, because this problem actually happened to me, so I'm pretty sure it's gonna happen to a bunch of other people. So if you guys get to see one of my videos, you guys will be satisfied with the solution that I'm when I find out, I'll be able to show it to you guys and all that, and I'll showcase it, and then I'll officially show you how to install the Spotify and also get premium the right way, because it's not that simple. You don't just install Spotify and click on the script and bam, you're good. You have to do a bunch of other things, get on your properties. You gotta close Spotify at a certain time. I mean, it's just a bunch of things you gotta do. And but at the end of the day, it's pretty easy. You know, if you watch the whole video, you'll get it, and it's gonna be pretty easy. It's not gonna be too exhausting or anything like that. Not exhausting at all. It's gonna be pretty quick, pretty I'm gonna be pretty thorough, but it's gonna be pretty quick at the end of the day. But there you go, you guys. But yeah, that's pretty much it. And that's how you clean out, destroy everything on your hard on your drive, whatever it is, wipe it clean. That is how you do it. And like I said, I'm gonna put in the Rufus application there. I might turn it into a file dropper link, because I don't know. I just feel like, because I don't know if you can put links on there, but I think the only way of doing it is file dropper, because there's actually a file, and I'm gonna go ahead and do it. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope this really helped a lot of you guys out there who are watching. Please drop a like if this really did help you, and you guys and really enjoy this video. Please comment down below if for any questions, or feel free to email me. Go to my channel, my email's right there. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Most of you guys email me anyway, because I don't know, but pretty much all the comments that I've been getting were all just positivity, and I'm really grateful for all those. So far, I haven't gotten any hate, no negativity, none of that, and I really appreciate that. But yeah, I mean, it's okay to get hate here and there. People hate. I get it. I mean, that's the cruel world out here. But yeah, there you go. I'm not gonna sit here and lecture all day long. Yeah, like and subscribe if you guys really enjoyed. Got any questions, whatever, like, subscribe, email me, or comment down below whatever question you got, and I'll happily check. As you can see, I reply to every question that anybody asks me. But if anybody drops a positivity comment, I'll just love it, and that's also a sign that I've actually read it. And yeah, I actually keep in track of all the comments that I get. But that's the end of the video, you guys. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys really enjoyed for the last time, because I've already said that like 5 times, but, And yeah, peace.